Good morning, students. So this is for BTech 6M textile technology, textile chemistry and textile engineering students under the subject textile testing part 2. So today we'll discuss the three fabric properties. One is bending or flexural rigidity, how we measure this. Second is crease recovery, and third is drape, which is related to stiffness of the fabric. First, we'll understand how we measure bending characteristics of a fabric. So the most popular stiffness tester is Shirley stiffness tester, whose line diagram is shown here, and it is based on cantilever principle, in which horizontal strip of fabric is allowed to bend like cantilever under its own weight. It is based on one empirical equation given by Pierce, and the angle is 41.5 degree, which is standard for this instrument. Now the green line shown here is the fabric sample, and we just slide the fabric sample from one side, and fabric starts bending on its own weight, and the moment it touches this inclined line, we measure the overhanging length of the fabric, which is equal to L in this formula, where G is the flexural rigidity, M is the mass per unit area of the fabric, and L is the overhanging length. We can also define here one more term, that is bending length of the fabric C, which is related to overhanging length L of the fabric by this formula given by Pierce. And we can see if we substitute theta is equal to 7.1 degree, we get this function as trigonometric function equal to 1. So at theta is equal to 7.1 degree, bending length is equal to overhanging length. But this instrument is based at theta is equal to 41.5 degree. So at theta is equal to 41.5 degree, bending length is half of the overhanging length. If we'll calculate this function. So these are the specimen dimensions, and we calculate the flexural rigidity. There is one more method to calculate rigidity of a fabric, which is hanging loop method, which is less popular. In this case, basically we take the fabric strip and we just clamp it in this way, as shown schematically here. Hot loop test, we call it. This is the way. So if we just clamp the fabric here, fold and here, clamp here, the stiffer fabric will show some curve like this, which is which resembles hot, and the limpier fabric will show the curve like this, which resembles pier. So with this diagram, we can understand estimate the stiffness of the fabric. One more term we use here, that is ring loop method. Ring loop method is used for measuring the flexural rigidity of the fiber or yarn, in which case we just make a circular loop of the fiber or yarn and hang a specific very small amount of weight on it, and we just measure the deformation produced in that circular loop, which becomes elliptical when we hang the weight. So we just measure the deformation produced and relate it to the flexural rigidity of the fiber or yarn. Now here one more thing we need to understand, one more term, which is bending modulus. Bending modulus is a term which is used to measure the intrinsic stiffness, which is equal to basically flexural rigidity divided by cube of thickness of the fabric. So to eliminate the effect of the thickness and to compare the bending rigidities of two fabric, we should go for this term, that is bending modulus. Now the next thing is drape, which is also one of the important property, and the definition of drape is how a fabric hangs under its own weight, and we measure it by this Cusick drape test, and its value range from 0 to 1, And in this case, we take a circular specimen of the fabric and a support disc of smaller dia as compared to fabric. And we just put the fabric specimen on the support disc or anvil. And we measure the shaded area divided by total area, gives us an idea about the drape coefficient. But if it is difficult to, it is difficult to measure the area of the curved boundaries, so we measure basically the weight of the sample, if considering that GSM is constant all over the sample and area is directly proportional to mass of the fabric. So this formula can be converted in terms of mass. This drape coefficient is equal to mass of shaded area divided by total mass of paper ring. Now we'll move to third property, that is crease recovery. As we all know, wool and silk have better resistance to creasing, and all the natural cellulosics are very easy to crease. So how do we measure this? The most common test is Shirley crease recovery test, and the instrument looks like this. In this case, we take a 2 inch into 1 inch sample of the fabric and we fold the fabric exactly at the center and put a weight of 2 kg for 1 minute and give a specific recovery time, and hang it here and give a specific recovery time and measure the recovery in units of degree, which is theoretically maximum it can be 180 degree. So crease recovery is an important measurement to measure the wash and wear finish also, and its unit is degrees. So I'll complete here and we'll continue in the next class. Thank you.